Let's go back to this idea of a security and a utility, and kind of, can something have, you know, properties of both? Can it transition between the two, et cetera? And so, you know, in the traditional non-crypto world, there's shareholders that hold equity, and there is utility to sometimes being a shareholder, access to a shareholder meeting or event, that type of stuff. But for the most part, outside of, you know, some kind of more gimmicky type stuff, if you hold a security, it's a security, and there's not much utility to it other than the value, the appreciation, et cetera. In this world, we're seeing kind of the blending or that blurring of those lines. What excites you the most in terms of, you know, as long as people continue to follow rules and regulators kind of work with them, et cetera, like, what do you think is possible there, right? Is it the Binance model, or is there other things that you think could possibly be, this kind of blended security utility could be used for that could be compelling to either investors or holders of the token that use it in an incentive model?
Yeah, I think that my favorite utility, for the most part, I hate utility tokens. Mm-hmm. I think that they have little utility. I think that there hasn't been a single utility token, a pure utility token, that I've seen designed that has thoughtfully, you know, figured out how it could work at a future high demand equilibrium state.
But even Ether.
Yes, including Ether. But I think that my favorite actual utility token example is something like Sia. Mm-hmm. I find Sia's model pretty compelling. And the way it works is they have two different tokens. One is an equity, a traditional sort of equity token, where it has all of the sort of same class structures as equity would have. And it has a separate utility token, which is used for participating in the network, that has a lot of the qualities that utility tokens have. In their future, sort of high demand, high throughput state, it's highly unlikely that the utility token is ever going to make a good investment. And mm-hmm. they're clear with that from day one. But what it does offer is, exactly what it describes, right? It helps access utility in their network. While the security structure actually provides recourse for investors, right? And they have some claim, and it aligns incentives for the team. Because I think the problem with most utility tokens is that there's a strict conflict oftentimes that emerges between the incentives of the team and the incentives of their potential users and the incentives of their potential investors. Oftentimes, these three things aren't totally aligned, mm-hmm. right? A universe where there's high velocity in utility systems, and these network tokens are these networks actually do see high usage rates, is actually one where users benefit, but the team or investors might not necessarily be incentivized to, you know, do work on it or participate as an investment. In sort of a fixed supply world, oftentimes these are it's problematic for users while being more beneficial for the team or for investors. And there's all sorts of models that people have come up with to try to work around this. There, mm-hmm. you know, there's token bonding curves and kind of mint and burn models, and people are, you know, they're trying all sorts of things, right? They're throwing a lot of things at the wall, experimenting with crypto economics and tokenomics and, you know, all of these sort of LinkedIn buzzwords almost. But the reality is that I find the security utility token, that kind of dual token structure that has clearly delineated what the incentives are for each party and aligning all of those in the same direction, I find that super compelling. I think it's really cool.